I'm so glad to be here. This is like Disney World, NPR. I grew up in a house that had NPR on it all the time, so I do contribute. Thank you. I contribute financially, and now I feel like I'm contributing and giving y'all something back. So this is a real honor for me, and this next song is the title track of the album. It's called Say It Louder. It's about regret. I imagine everybody in here knows about that.
Thank you.
say it again, I'd say it louder if I had a way to walk down that road again. I'd run faster. Time doesn't slip away. You let it. You turn to look away. You'll regret it. I know this now, baby. I learned the hard way that for your love, I'm a little too. If I knew that you were barely hanging on, I would have held you a little tighter through the night so that by dawn I would not have lost you. And I let it down. So if I had the chance to say it again, I'd say it louder. Thank you. Sitting at my computer one day, and a friend sent me an email of a YouTube clip, and they said, I don't know if you know this, but Bon Iver is singing your song. And I was like, I did not know that. Wow. So I went and watched it and noticed that there are all, you know, multiple clips of it from different nights and everything. And I was really flattered. I was a fan of his, and I had my people get in touch with his people and say, I'd love to meet him, because he was coming to Nashville about a month later to play a show. And so we met that night and had dinner and got to know each other. And then I sang on stage with him on that night. And then we've gone on to become good friends, and I toured with them in Europe and things like that. But he actually found me through the record I made with Bill Frisell in 2002. And that album is called Covered. And he really just had been buying my records ever since as a fan. He had tried to come to a couple of my shows in Nashville, but, you know, lived in North Carolina and Wisconsin at different times and could never quite make it work. And so he had bought my record studio living room, which is the record I put out in 2006, and learned the song off of there. Which, the funny story is that if you see him sing it, he sings the first chorus over and over and never sings the second chorus. And I said to him when I met him, I was like, what's with the second chorus? You don't like the second chorus? He was like, no, it's just that when I learned it, I put it on loop. And I learned the verses in the first chorus, and then I looped it and looped it over and over and over. So I just always sang the first chorus. I never went past that. So I do it the original way, so it's a little different. Although he's influenced a couple of chord shifts and things like that, because I've heard his version so much and done it with him. So.
Yeah, nice.
We're hoping to. Okay. We're working on an idea. Yeah.
Thank you.